a PPT on importance of LinkedIn for MBA students. So let's dive into this topic. So the contents for this presentation would be what is LinkedIn, how to get started, why a college student should be on LinkedIn, and how it is helpful, some facts and figures about LinkedIn. And the next is what are LinkedIn groups and what are its benefits. Next is how it is useful for MBA students and some to-do list for MBAs, profile building tips and what to put in headline and some headline examples, and LinkedIn for businesses, how it is useful for business. And at last, conclusion, and then at last, references and sources. So let's get started first. So what is LinkedIn? So LinkedIn is basically a social media platform for educational purpose or for a professional purpose. So it is basically an American business and employment-oriented online service that provides employment to various of its users. And on this platform, we can demonstrate our skills and talent to the world. And it is a very useful platform for us. So if we want our skills to be recognized by some other people, or if we want to get any job based on our skills, so it's a very important platform for that purpose. Now, next slide. So how to get started on LinkedIn? So first you have to create your profile, and the profile building is very basic thing and very most important thing. Like whenever any recruiter will come to see you, so what basically he will do is just see your profile, and he will get an idea about you through your profile. So profile building is the most important and most relevant thing to do. And the next thing would be to build your network. And by network building, I mean that to enhance your network. Like you can follow your classmates, your colleagues, or your some favorite leaders, so that you can be regular updated by the post that they share. And the second is, if you are a job seeker, you can find a job in the job search section on LinkedIn, and you can find any type of job. And if you are a student and you want to do an internship, you can also find internships on that. And the second, fourth one is participate in conversations. You can also build your network through like conversating with some other peoples, or like if a person is in the company which you are interested in, and you can ask, you can conversate with him or her. And this last is post contents. So it's like you can also post contents. You can also post contents of your choice or of your interest. Or if you are a company head, you can post contents related to your company or hiring, so that people whosoever will be interested can contact you. Next. So why should a college student be on LinkedIn? So the first and the foremost thing is for a college student, what is the most important thing to do? It's to find a job or an internship, so that they can be recognized by a company, or so to find a job is the most and the foremost important thing. So so that is the main reason that a student should be on LinkedIn, and because it's very easy to find a job there. And second is to build a strong professional network. So it means that if you are in college and you have and you don't want to get a job right now, you can do what? Like you can share your skills, your certificates, or anything that you are interested in on this platform. Next, and so how it is useful? So it is useful in many ways. The first would be increase your exposure, so you can always explore more and more on this platform. And by exposure, you can also explore the companies that you want to go in, and you can follow your leaders and you can see that what they are up to. And you can also follow your colleagues and what and see that what they are doing right now, or is there anything that you can that is useful for you. And the second is get recommendations and endorsements. So it is also one of the most important thing to be on LinkedIn. Like recommendation is that if you want to go into a company and you want and head of the company wants you to be recommended by someone of in that company only. So if you have any friend on LinkedIn who is in that company, you can ask for recommendations from him or her, so that you can get into that company easily. And the endorsements is like if you like there is a section of skills and achievements on your profile. So if you have any skills, you can add their skills and you can be get endorsed by someone who thinks that you are really good at this skill. So that is what endorsement is. And the third point is like a third point of how LinkedIn is helpful. It is helpful in job searching, as I have already told it. Like it is very easy to find a job on it. Because most of the recruiters are on this platform, so that's why. And the fourth reason is effective platform for marketing. So if you have your own business and you want and it's a startup you want to maximize your products, or you want people to know about your company. So it is a very effective and very best platform for marketing such things. Next, continue. And some other reasons that how LinkedIn is helpful. One would be learn about companies you are interested in. So you can always search for companies which, like, if you want to go into Google, you can always search for like if there is any updates regarding hiring or regarding anything that you may be interested. And next is follow your favorite people. So as I have told that you can always follow any leaders or anyone whom you think is good or whom you think that you can get something useful from them. And the last is provide mutual benefits for businesses and individuals. As I have told, it provides benefits to both businesses that they can market their products on LinkedIn. And individuals also, like, they can be get endorsed or recommended by someone who's on LinkedIn, or they can find jobs or anything. Next. So there are some facts and figures of LinkedIn. Like, there are over 760 million users on LinkedIn currently, and the total monthly active users are 260 million. And LinkedIn is considered to be the most credible source of content, because like on Instagram, you see like it is full of memes and stuff like that on it. And on Facebook also, it is also filled with memes and some rubbish stuff also. But in LinkedIn, it is the most credible source of content because you won't find any irrelevant thing on LinkedIn. So that's the most best thing about it. And the next is the best social network for lead generation. So if you want to generate leads for your, like if you are a company and you want some leads for your products or for your courses, if you're selling courses, so it is considered to be the, so LinkedIn is considered to be the best platform for such lead generation. And the second is 20 million companies listed with 87% of recruiters regularly use LinkedIn. So that is also a very important thing that the companies like 87% of the companies use LinkedIn, and they regularly post on it if they are hiring or if they are recruiting at any times. So that in this sense, it is very useful. Next. So this is some data of how LinkedIn is growing. In the second chart, we can see that how, like, which of the following social media channels are a part of your digital marketing mix. So LinkedIn is considered best for a digital marketing, and after that Twitter. And in the first picture, we can see the numbers by how LinkedIn is distributing content and how it and how it is considered most effective for lead generation. Next. And the next important thing for MBA students is that what are LinkedIn groups? Because for an MBA student, they mostly deal with businesses. So for a business to grow, LinkedIn groups is very important. So let's see what it is. So it's a hub on LinkedIn. The people with similar professions in the same industry. So it's a hub for that. And they, like, if we are from engineers, so a LinkedIn group would be for the engineer students only, in which we will all share some relevant contents that can be useful for everyone there. And it is, as I told you, it is very important for MBA students because as they deal with businesses, so whenever they have to discuss something or whenever they are hiring or recruiting, they can easily post on these groups, and anyone can join these groups. So that is important. Next. So here are the benefits of LinkedIn groups. So the benefits are, so the first and the my favorite benefit is, like, we can learn about webinars and workshops. Like, if we are joining any educational groups, like educational groups like Geeks for Geeks or anything like that. So we will get to learn about many webinars and many free workshops that they conduct regularly. So that is very important thing for a student only, that they can always be in touch with these webinars and workshops. And the second is for MBAs and or anyone who is having a business, so they can enhance their brand by in LinkedIn groups, as there are many people in LinkedIn groups, so they can easily enhance their brands. And the third is increase communication skills. So to be in LinkedIn groups, so we will have to talk to each other. So this can increase our communication skills very well. And the fourth is allow you to gain influence quickly. So like you can be influenced by the others in that group. Like if they are doing this, you will also be get motivated or influenced by them easily. And the last is powerful problem solving at your fingertips. So it means that if you have any doubts or if you have any questions, you can ask in that group, and anyone in that group can solve that question or can clear your doubts. So you can easily get yourself clear when you will be in a LinkedIn group. Next. So continue. So as I have told, like, you can clear your doubts and ask questions always. And there is always valuable content in any group. So you will not find any irrelevant contents in that group. So everything will be of your interest or of your interest that you have chosen to join this group. And the last and the important thing is that you can build your network by being in any LinkedIn groups. Next. So here are some snapshots of any LinkedIn group. So the first one is Step Into the Spotlight. So this is a LinkedIn group in which there are some members, and here it's written about this group, like what will be the activities in this group. So you can easily join these groups. There is a section on LinkedIn to join the groups. So you can join from that. Next. So how LinkedIn is useful for MBAs? So it defines the career path. It means that you can easily, after seeing LinkedIn posts and everything that's going on inside it, you can come to a conclusion that what you have to do or what is your career path. And as I have discussed that it is very easy to find a job or internship on this if you have relevant skills and accomplishments or any experiences. So it is very easy to find job on there. And the third is the best platform to connect with professionals. As I have discussed this, that it is the best platform if you want to connect with any professional people of any like or any of your teachers or any of your colleagues or any leaders, you can easily connect with them. Next. So here is some to-dos list for MBA students. And the first and the most important would be to update your profile regularly. So this is very important in order to get a job or an internship. Like, you will have to update your profile regularly. If you will not update, so like you will have to be active on LinkedIn so that people can see you or can recognize you. Second is explore and invite new colleagues to connect. So this is also important, like always explore and always try to invite new colleagues so that you can connect with them. And recommend someone. So it's like a tit for tat. If you would recommend someone, the next person would also think to recommend you. But it does not work like this. But if you would recommend someone who is relevant for that job or something or anything, so he will also try to consider you. And this next is endorse someone and also ask for yours. So asking for endorsement is nothing shame. You can always ask for endorsement and also endorse anyone. Next, continue. So ask for recommendations. You can ask for, if you are going into a company and you want to be recommended by someone, you can ask for recommendations from that company colleagues only. And explore and join groups of interest. So as I have told, LinkedIn groups are very important. So you can always explore your interest and try to join as much as groups you can. And always be active on LinkedIn. Like, not just waste your time on LinkedIn, but be active means like, at least try to check it once in a day. That is enough for you. Yeah. And the next is regularly apply for internships and jobs. So yeah, if you will regularly apply for internships and jobs, you will easily be considered. Next. So it is a job portal of LinkedIn. You can find this window below written as LinkedIn jobs. So you can always search of your interest jobs or you can also apply some filters to it. So this is basically that. Next. And here are some profile building tips, like how you can build your profile efficiently and attractively. The first is revise profile in the light of your course. So whatever your course you have, you should always revise your profile and like update your profile regularly in the light of your course. Like if you are MBA doing in HR, so you always try to do things which comes under that. And present your best self. Always try to express your best self. Like, don't, if you have any small skill also, you try to show it there. So that is to present your best self. Next is show your achievements and certifications. So this is also important to be considered by recruiters, to show your achievement, whatever achievements you have or whatever certificates you have, always try to show it on LinkedIn or always try to add skills, more and more skills to your profile. Next. Continue. So networking is important and always try to build your network and follow top leaders and your college alumni so that you can see that what they are up to. And need an impressive and detailed profile. Sorry, there's a spelling mistake, I think. So yeah, always try to detail yourself. Try to detail everything that is in profile. Not try to write paragraphs or something. Always try to be short and very detailed inside that short sentence. Next. Continue. So the most important thing is your profile photo also. So it says a lot. It should be a very professional type of, like, should be of a very plain black background or of your single photo, portrait mode, like. And the next is genuine skills and endorsement. So try to show your genuine skills or endorsements. You can ask for anyone. So yeah, and express yourself in a very creative way. So in the about section, you will always have to be very creative, so that, because whenever someone comes to your profile, they don't have much time to read all of the things that's there. You have to be very specific about the things and very creative about the things, so that you can say a lot in a very small sentence. And the headline that comes below your name is very important. Next. So what to put in headline? So here are some examples, and the headline should be very, very small and very specific about what you are doing and what you are up to. You can also add some of your best skills in headline. So here are some examples, like this is by Lisa Hangel. Lead with true differentiators, keywords, or achievements. So these are some, like, you can add these things to your headline, like show your area of interest also, and expertise the student hopes to use. You can also include MBA candidate in your headline, as long as you also indicate your core fields and skills. Next is. Next, add information like target jobs, keywords, and you should be very specific about the keywords that you are using in your headline. And like, there are some keywords that job recruiters always search for, so you should pick out that keywords and try to put it in the headline. So find a niche that grabs decision makers' attention and fulfills a need. So try to grab those keywords that is very attractive and can easily grab the attention and fulfills your need. Next. So these are some examples of, like, some MBA students, like, they can put in their headline that marketing, business development, and advertising, branding for marketing differentiation and analysis, 2018 Northwestern MBA. So these are, so here are some examples. You can see that. Next. So here are some profiles of some of the MBA students. The first one is Abby Stern. So in her headline, it's written that MBA candidate at Stanford graduates schools of business. So she's very specific about, and you can see her summary that whatever she's up to, she has written in a very creative way. And this is the next profile. Next. And how LinkedIn is important for businesses. So, like, in businesses, you always, like, there are times when you have to recruit some people, or you have to replace some people, or that thing. So you can easily recruit people from LinkedIn. And reputation management, so you can always manage your businesses through LinkedIn. Like, you can ask for advices for some famous people or some professionals. And the third is networking. So networking, so for a business, the networking is very important, and you can build network through LinkedIn. Next. So the conclusion of all that is that, so LinkedIn is basically important for every student in today's world, not only for MBAs. It is important for everyone who is a job seeker or who is also in job, because like, it enhances your skills, and it is very for a student they can always search for internships that are available on that. And for a job seeker, they can search for jobs there. And for an MBA student, profile building is the most important part. So if they will have the very best profile, they can easily be considered by the companies. And the thing that I have discussed is the LinkedIn groups that are essential for an MBA because it helps to promote your brand if you have any business, and it helps to increase your skills and you build your network. Next. So these are some references and sources. And at last, thank you so much for listening.